is an interesting approach, and using all values that we have discussed so far, we try to make a simulation to see what would be the detection of the F-35. We are talking about aft sector, and with the use of a state-of-the-art IRST system. Okay, they evolve, so we have better sensors. Suppose now we have an F-16 with a very good IRST system. What would be the scenario? This is what we've seen before. This is the active electronic scan array APG-83. And now we made some simulations during last month. And these are the results from our work, which is still unpublished. But I think that they're quite accurate. This is the detection range of an IRST in medium field of view. We have wide field of view, medium, and narrow. This is a medium field of view in rainy weather. One major problem of IR systems is that they are prone to weather. If there is rain or moisture, the detection is much lower. So if it rains, we get something like that. If we have just dust or haze, it's something like that. If we're talking about good weather, I think that this is now interesting. And in very dry weather, the detection outperforms the radar of the F-35. Of course, we are talking about aft sector detection. If we're talking about frontal sector, it would be approximately 2/3 of these values. USFOs, they have been using IRST systems since the 50s. However, during the 80s, due to development in radar systems, they seem to abandon the idea of IRST. And the last aircraft with a decent IRST system was the Tomcat, the F-14B, the Super Tomcat, not Top Gun, later on, in the 90s, which was retired in 2006. However, it seems that during the last years, they have again rediscovered IRST systems and generally electro-optical systems. So we talk about the F-35 with two electro-optical systems. Also, they have been selling IRST systems to their customers, like this one, the Tiger Eyes in Singapore, or the IFDS system, this one, to the United Arab Emirates. And most recently, they proposed the Legion pod. This is the sensor, the old sensor of the F-14, of course upgraded, on a pod. And also, more recently, the open pod by Northrop Grumman. So I think that there is some kind of resurrection of IRST in the USFOs. The Europeans, all of them equipped their aircraft with systems like that. Even though in the Rafale it is now supposed to be obsolete, and they are going to design a new one for the next standard. That's why I said that in Eurofighter, it's, for the time being, maybe the best IRST in use. And this is the one that will be used in Gripen, and which is openly published as anti-stealth. They say clearly that they can find any stealth with this system, this sensor. Concerning the Russians, IRST systems are standard equipment on all fighters since the 60s. Trying to make a recap of all these things, let's see a simple scenario of an F-35 trying to attack of the red land, to attack a target of the blue land. And let's suppose that this is the border is 100 nautical miles away from the target, and at the same position there is a radar. Let's suppose it's a low frequency band radar, so we can see stealth targets approximately at this distance. So at t equals 0, the intruder flying low. If it flies at Mach 0.9, which is more or less 600 knots, in 2 minutes it will have traveled 20 nautical miles, and we are still under the radar horizon. The radar cannot detect this target because it is flying very low. Let's suppose that there is no gap filler, passive radars or whatever. So at this moment, the radar is expected to have a first detection of the target, of the intruder. And it will order, given a scramble order to QRA fighters. This is quick reaction alert fighters. Within the next 5 minutes, let's suppose that the QRA fighters take off within 5 minutes from the alert, from the scramble order. At this time, the intruder will have traveled 70 nautical miles, and it will start gaining height, gaining altitude, in order to deliver its weapons in maximum range. 1.5 minutes later, the F-35 will have reached a decent altitude in order to release its 2 JDAM smart bombs against the target. And at the same time, the QRA fighters, the interceptors, will try to gain speed and altitude in order to find and intercept the target, the intruder. Well, the target may be destroyed or not. If the target is well defended by a short-range air defense system, like a CRAM, CRAM is a counter rocket artillery mortar system. I mean, the 2 JDAM bombs are not something of an exotic kind of weapon, it's just 2 bombs. If you have a decent air defense system, you can shoot the bombs and save the target. Anyway, in our scenario, this is irrelevant, it may have been destroyed or not. The attacker will be turning back to Redland, and now the interceptors are trying to find him again. At that time, he cannot use his missiles against targets in the rear hemisphere. Okay, since the aircraft is looking at this way, he cannot fire a missile that will do a U-turn. This has happened only with the Rafale and Eurofighter, to the best of my knowledge. So he's being chased. 2 minutes later, the intruder will make a great mistake. He will activate his afterburner, feeling that the interceptor aircraft are chasing him, and looking at his radar warning receiver, he sees that they are painting him with their radars, and so he's anxious, he activates his afterburner, and he becomes a very good source of radiation, of infrared radiation, that it can be picked up by the IRST that the QRA fighters have. So he can be, they can make indirect range measurement and fire a salvo of missiles. This is radar and this is IR, because if you fire only a radar missile, maybe the missile will miss the target. Remember the first one of the first slides with the curves. You remember that the missile radar has lower detection range compared to the aircraft and of course to the surveillance radar. So you may see it with the radar. The radar may send the track via Link 16 to the fighter, but the fighter may not see the F-35. And if he sees it with his radar, maybe the missile will miss it. That's why you have to shoot different kind of missiles. Radar and IR. And he's dead. Of course, life is not so simple. And in a real case, there are other things that matter, like tactics, like training, like apart from technology and means, the fog of war, and of course luck. But we can see from this scenario, first, that the stealth aircraft is a tough guy. If it were not the stealth, he would not deliver the bombs in the first place. And second, he is not invincible. Okay, let's conclude. Now we see that all military vehicles, aircraft, tanks, ships, etc., are all designed or redesigned, taking into account low observable techniques. Stealthiness is not panacea, it's not a cloak of invisibility or invincibility, if there is such a word. And it is not easy to confront a stealth threat with only one kind of radar. You have to use a multi-spectral approach in different kinds of the spectrum. A promising approach would use low frequency band radars for medium and high altitude surveillance, passive radars for the lower tier of the space, data fusion of any sensor, trying to find if there is something, even though it cannot produce a valid track on its own. Transfer info and the track to the target of the target via data link, via Link 16, to the fighter or even to the missile itself. And use IRST system in order to try to find the stealth threat. So, closing with this beautiful picture of the F-35 at the US Air Museum, I thank you for your attention. Thank you very much.